What's up, everybody? Jim Resonated Lee here from ClimateViewer.com with an explosive update. Hold on to your pants. Today we're going to talk about nuclear explosions. Now, a lot of us were taught in school that there were two nuclear explosions. They happened at Hiroshima and Nagasaki during World War II, ended that abruptly. And that's just not the case. There were 2,053 explosions across the world during the Cold War. Seems like they were in a fireworks contest when you look at the map. Now, this is from a guy from the Google Earth forums. What I did was I took his file and I added these little icons to kind of dress it up, give it flair, and reformatted all the information in them. So big credit to him for that. And this is Nevada, and you got to see this. I mean, these are the holes in the ground. All right, they're still there. And these are upper air explosions. And then you even have underground explosions. This is a little map that was also provided by the aforementioned fellow from the Google Earth forums. Check that out. I mean, it's just nuts. Absolutely nuts. This blew my mind when I first saw it, especially, you know, the one up here in the air. I'm sure everybody enjoyed breathing that. That was in 1955. Teapot. Good. Airdrop parachute retarded. So they dropped it with a parachute and blew it up right over America. Additionally, here's some more that they did in America. And of particular interest to Salt Dome followers is Cowboy Plowboy Carry Salt Mine. And then two over here in a Whetstone Salmon Tatum Salt Dome. So they love the salt domes. Good stuff. They like to store nuclear waste and fracking material in there and all kinds of other things. But let's continue on. These red dots I just put up there are coal ash ponds. Very disgusting stuff. I'm going to go ahead and turn that off. Now, if you check out this map, what we have, the red ones, these red icons, are storage facilities. That is an incomplete file. I've still got a long way to go on it. If you guys want to help me out with that, submit your location, submit location URLs to websites where a lot of this information can be stored. So anything you can help out, I'd appreciate. So 2,364 nuclear weapons at Bangor, Washington, Air Force bases, places that dismantle them. Hanford nuclear site, original very first nuclear reactor in America or in the world was built here, as well as many other things of particular interest. Here, let me find it real quick. You go to electromagnetic and just turn that on. Check the down arrow to expand it, then check the box to show it, and you'll see that right here is the Hanford nuclear LIGO, which is a laser interferometer gravitational wave observatory. You guys may be wondering what that is, what that's, and also you can check the Wikimapia button here, and it'll overlay all kinds of great info from the amazing website Wikimapia. And you just click these and they'll click you over to it. Anyway, amazing stuff going on here. This LIGO, coincidentally, is here because Gravitational Hill is like right over here somewhere in this area is what's called Gravity Hill, where cars actually roll uphill. Very cool. But anyway, I did a video on this Hanford nuclear as well, and you'll see here over 1 million gallons of nuclear waste has leaked out of 67 single well tanks into the river, which is right there. But anyway, I digress. Let me turn this electromagnetic. All of my hard work is in the locations file. Check these three boxes. You got Big Brother, You got nuclear and you got electromagnetic in there. Just amazing stuff. That took me a year and a half to put together, by the way. Anyway, the yellow ones are nuclear power plants. You can double click them and they'll fly you in, let you look at them. Pretty cool. I want to breathe that. And then when you want to zoom all the way back out, click the little camera icon up here and you'll fly back out. And then you can see worldwide, that is a lot of nuclear explosions. A lot. Including the Russians, they got a grip over here. Well, trying to find, there you go, there's a pile. And I believe there's a bunch right here. Yeah. So just an overwhelming amount of nuclear explosions. That is your cause for cancer, people. And additionally, now most people will talk about Fukushima and how bad the radiation in the water is. And I'll tell you that this isn't all of it. All right, guys. Now this is on March is the last this was modeled, but that's how big they assumed the cesium spread in the water was. And that's from one nuclear power plant. All right. This just happened. Russian nuclear graveyard found with 17,000 containers of radioactive waste, 19 ships containing radioactive waste, 14 nuclear reactors, including five that still contain spent nuclear fuel, 735 other pieces of radioactively contaminated heavy machinery, and the K-27 nuclear submarine with its two reactors loaded with fuel. Yummy. All right, so, and there's the link for that. Great day. That really just, you know, sent a shiver up my spine. Crazy stuff. So while I was researching that, like I said, the nuclear waste and storage is going to grow exponentially. I'm going to be adding many more locations, such as, I found this. This is archive.org for websites that web pages that have been deleted from the internet. This originally appeared at american.edu/TED/JapanC. It has now been deleted. Thank you, archive.org. The former Soviet Union and now Russia have reportedly dumped radioactive waste on the sea in the Sea of Japan since 1950s. When I was going through this, you see here, it says case number 255. There are many of these pages, and I've been going through and saving them as quickly as possible. So I'm going to put all these together and then put them all on the map eventually. But there is some amazing blow-your-mind stuff in here, including agreements between America and Africa to dump our nuclear and other hazardous waste in their homelands. And just, I mean, heartbreaking stuff, but it'll get on the map eventually. So that's the nuclear stuff. There's a lot there to look at. You know, and of course, you know, check out the Fukushima section. But there's also a tsunami tracker. We'll show you the floating debris. And this is the estimate in March. Yowza. So the other story that everybody's been asking about is the Bayou corn thing. So let's touch on that real fast, and then I'm going to wrap this up. Now, the black ones are oil wells, and you can highlight the info right here, and it's kind of a pain. And I'm going to come up with a better converter in the future, but I had to convert it all to text. So just highlight that, right-click it, and go to that URL. It'll kick you over to their DNR, and you can look at the PDFs on, you know, for the wells history, when they got permits, their inspection records, that sort of thing. I also put in water wells, so you can see where all the water wells are in the area. And you may be wondering why I'm doing such a big area. The paper that's referenced here, Salt, A World of History, they said that it turned out that, you know, up to 4 miles away, somebody could be the culprit. So it doesn't have to necessarily be the well right by the hole. So get digging. You never know what you'll find. And then the last thing I want to touch on is the New Madrid. A lot of people are talking about, you know, this and the New Madrid, and I found something kind of creepy, and I just want to point it out. This is the recent earthquakes, according to the USGS. Now, if you'll see right here, they've got one up there, and they should have everything from the past week. Now, you come over here to external links, and you click EarthScope USArray. Now, this is the EarthScope. I'm going to bring it up over here while we're watching this. And you'll see that there are many more earthquakes than are showing on that map. And these are all from the last day or two. You know, the third, the sixth. I mean, those aren't on there. Come on, they're 2 days ago. Why aren't they on that map? But yeah, that's kind of concerning for me. And then over here, you got these as well, right up on the surface. Nice. So, yeah, I don't know. Not making any assumptions. Maybe this is normal, but look into it if you're interested in the New Madrid and earthquakes, and plenty of links here in the external link section. The nuclear section, the external links, has radiation monitoring. I have no scripts. I'm just making sure that everything's going to run. Pretty cool. And I believe this is live. So check that out. Lots of stuff in here. Check the external links. You know, there's some videos in here. I have a whole video playlist on nuclear energy. I'm going to add way more to this. I just added all these external links into the map. Get involved. EarthScope. Here you go. It's now loaded. This is a very large file, so I clicked it earlier. So we'll go ahead and load. This is where that data is coming from. And as you can see, it's a traveling, roaming seismic station array. And it's got multiple purposes, but you know, it also tracks earthquakes. So enjoy that, guys, and get involved in the project. You know, I could use some help here. And if you have a story that is climate pollution related, weather modification, anything like that, earth changes, disasters, give it to me. I'd love to put it in there. And all you got to do is hold your control key and click on the map, and it'll put a little dot on there with the road info and everything. And you can hold your alt key and edit it, type my concerns or whatever you want to put, and then put some information in. You can even put URLs to links to news. And then come up here and hit save and hit OK. And hit save. And then you can email me this file, and then I'll know exactly what you're talking about. And I'll just add it to Google Earth and put it up here in this little tree. And there you have it. And if that's a little too complicated for you, feel free to jump up here in the forum and just log into that bad boy and post your news. We've already had a couple people posting. I really appreciate it, guys. The more the merrier. Let's build a map of all the bad places so we can get to cleaning it up. I appreciate it, guys, and I hope to hear from you soon. And I'll be updating you as soon as I can. This instructional video at the top, I will be updating that in like the next day or two. So you guys stay safe out there, and I appreciate you watching this video.